of aliens. Infiltration results in irritation. Irritation gives you ulceration. Ulceration radiates the part and deepens it and permeates to the other portions. Before this permeation and radiation happens, the NSP neural signal processing, it must control the disease. That stage of treacherous disease, which cannot be controlled, becomes cancerous in nature. So cancer is the name of the nature of a disease. Uncontrollability of a disease, it is not the name of a disease. So no disease can be belittled. I am going to give you the sutras, like Brahma sutras, sutras of healing. There are 300 sutras of healing. Sarve vyadigrastaha. All are having their own diseases in the incubation layer, or in the innate stage, or in the latent stage, or obvious stage, or fatal stage. It may be different. Everybody is having their own diseases. When they are ruled by resistance, all the other subjects, the denizens of the disease kingdom, they are submissive. And when the counterparty comes for the ruling, then all of the other body resistant elements, they come for subservience. So it is a combat. It is an eternal combat war happening inside the body. So the disease causing germs, they do not come from outside. They are verily available inside. So everybody is having a disease in various stages, starting from latent stage to an obvious or considerable stage. And any disease can come to any person. And no disease must be belittled at all. If you think that it is a throat irritation, it may be both a throat irritation, or it may be a symptom for ulceration, it may be a symptom for a deepened ulceration, it may be also a symptom which, if uncared, may become permeation and radiation, developing into a throat cancer. So no disease can be belittled. These are all the aphorisms of healing. Likewise, we have to practice these things, and we can practice this flow daily. If you practice this, there are a lot of blocks which I am going to deal later. These blocks can be removed very smoothly if they are in the peripheral or inceptive level. In the beginning level, we can eradicate these blocks by preventive methodology, Nivarana Shakti. 60% of the heart diseases can be prevented for us. And how to transmit? See, transmission is not just like that. For example, if you are eating here, the same process you are adopting for another person also. How to eat and how to feed others? If you put it in your mouth, that is eating. If you put it in somebody's mouth, that is feeding. But mission and transmission of energy, they are not equivalent. Something to get to your mouth, that is the energy canal, is not as easy as you are going to do somebody who does not believe you. I have already given the list of varieties of people. Those who are attached to you, not knowing you, antagonistic to you, lot of things I dealt. So it requires a different study. Today I have just taught you the process of strengthening your heart. And the transmission methodology, there are two things. It is very essential. It is very, very essential. This is a great, wonderful invention of our spiritual kingdom. It is Atmavat Bhava. It is Atmavat Bhava, identity. If you think about your person, you make two conversions. One, you think that you are having the disease. You think that this type of healing, I swear that in the world nobody knows, and only a limited esoteric parampara they knows. It is known as Atmavad Bhava. There are two Atmavad Bhavas. Thinking the person as himself. That is the own wisdom. In which you are thinking about your body, and in your body you are thinking about the heart block or something else, then it is not a superimposition or supraimposition. It is aropana or vyavasthapana or samsthapana. It is aropana, vyavasthapana, samsthapana. Suprapositioning. Like juxtaposition, it is not a supraposition or supraimposition. So you are thinking your body, and you are bringing the form of that disease or disease affected area inside your body. You are removing that. It is just like a remote. Remote has a significant resemblance and identity of operations. If you press volume, then the volume button or the volume response, there are two things. One is the operator, second is the respondent. And it is operated in the remote. And who is responding? The device is responding. But there is no counterwise response, you know that? Only the operator can do that. If they are bivalent, both the operator and receptacle, they can do that. But it is only unilateral. It cannot be done otherwise. By pressing the operations of a TV device, you cannot change the remote. But by pressing this, you can operate, you can activate them. You know that. So, that which having similarity, like volume, contrast, picture, sharpness, on, off, everything is there. The same configuration is known as configurative identity. That configurative identity is inside the television also. Where you are pressing this, you are getting that also done there. So that thing is mechanical and this thing is mystical. That is mechanical, this thing is mystical. By means of a yogic view or yogic power or by a deeper insight, you are thinking. See, by thinking that the other person's disease is yourself, that augments divine energy. There are two things for reducing and inducing energy. If you think the benefits of others as yours, your energy will be reduced. That car is the neighbor's. So many people are imagining that the car is theirs. At least with the avarice that they must possess that car. So, imagining something which is good from others, it is natural. And imagining others' problems as theirs, it is preternatural and supernatural. It is very essential part in healing. Most of the people, they treat that it is a disease for the other person. That's why the healing is more than 75% obstructed. And when a person, there must be a question. Yatha bhavo tatha bhavati. Whatever you think, you will become like that. So if I am thinking that I am having cardiac problem, for the sake of helping that person, will I get the problem by my imagination or by realization or by my contemplation? No, because it is tatkratu nyaya viparita. Today I am going to deal with that in Bhagavad Gita in today's evening lecture. Any person contemplating in any form, they will get the same effect. So Putana, you know Putana in Krishna's story. Krishna drank Putana's milk. So persons hearing this story, they must drink the milk of the mother naturally. But on the contrary, persons knowing this story, the Shastras say that they won't be born again in this world to drink the mother's milk again. Follow that. Krishna is tied with a rope. If you think of Krishna being tied with a rope, according to this yata bhava tata bhavati, you must be also tied with bondage. You are not being tied. On the contrary, you are released from the already existing bondage. Likewise, if you are thinking that other's disease is yours for contemplation and curing process, you are not only curing his disease, unaffected by his disease, but also your already existing diseases are eradicated. That is known as tatkratu nyaya viparita. Any person's imagining that others' diseases are theirs, and by bringing their diseases into their own parts, then having it rectified, then immediately you are the operator. Who is the respondent? The patient is the respondent. Who is the operator? You are the operator. So you are bringing, with configurative identity, you are bringing the heart problem, pulmonary vessel infection. You are bringing that to your heart. Then you are imagining, then by the process you are curing. Then immediately, as the remote control, the operation system that activates the respondent, whatever you do here, immediately the person is done there. So, the one more aphorism of healing is, you cannot cure the person within his body himself. That is a vital aphorism of healing. That is a thunder to all existing healing systems. You cannot cure any diseased person's disease in his body. You must shift or transplant his position to your own configurative identity, then get it cured, which will be having its own response in the other body's person by means of operative and respondent process of the remote controlling mechanism, which will give you not only the eradication assurance of his disease, but also your diseases, both mental, spiritual, along with the physical things will be eradicated for your broad-mindedness in which you are helping others. Could you follow that? Second, there is a pulmonary circulation of body. So keep your notes and just, you can, I think that you can shift your leg positions to make more comfortable. And I have already told about the systemic circulation, that is the outer circulation. In the inner circulation, there is a pulmonary circulation. So it starts from heart, from the pulmonary arteries, it reaches the lungs, then pulmonary veins, then it goes back to heart. Very simple. It must be very essential because it will help you in pranayama and it is a cure for cardiorespiratory diseases. Why I am telling this?